of January 2019, we're getting this show started at a very high note. It is a Monday, and for those of you just switched on your TVs wondering who's on your screens, Derek Dasha is right here to take you to up to 8 a.m. Today, what have you been up to? How was your weekend, folks? Welcome to great another show. I have, of course, the duo with me, Willis Daly, alongside Tina Fierce. Good morning to you.
Hey.
You know it's going to be a lit week if the very first song they play when you're on set is Mateka by Jose Camilo.
Like, you get what I'm talking about?
If you don't know what time it is yet, tubazuku sa wake up.
Miss Amon yesterday met me and said, Gwe, you crazy, but you sound intelligent. What's your purpose in life? I told them, I know.
You're crazy, but you sound intelligent.
Yeah, that's what they told me. We're here, intelligent people.
He is not.
We're intelligent people are only supposed to be serious people. But Simaya walk like this, talk like this, don't dance around. Man, me, I'm chill.
Gano, Mateka.
Meanwhile, I would like to send shout outs to our very own celebs.
Yes.
Ever since we made Kampala tobacco free, over the weekend there was a chuducha shisha. I'm telling you, I've just realized that Uganda Zab actually realized that Saturday night when I got the news. Understanding the fact that we have people who leave their countries, South Sudan, to come to Uganda and smoke shisha.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
But
one of the ministers was actually, you know, involved in the scaffold.
Wow.
Hey, hold on. Hey.
He was around in Uganda.
At that moment,
smoking shisha.
Hey.
So when they held him, I was like, no, please, I don't report this in my face.
Thank you for shouting out to us, our celebs. I'd like to send shout outs. Yesterday, I was on social media and I read a very hilarious meme. And this guy goes like, every girl, every bachelor house has a toothbrush that every girl uses and thinks she uses it alone. That is when I was like, big shout out to all the women who think it is just you, my dear. Even Jesus had 12 disciples. Chidawasem. If he hasn't wiped it, no time.
So polygamy is from the other side.
Why do you assume that every bachelor's house usually has
No. There is always...
Willis, listen.
Willis, if I walked into your bathroom right about now, isn't there an extra toothbrush?
There are two things.
Is there an extra toothbrush? There are two options.
If I'm a bachelor... If I'm a bachelor, which is F3, impossibility. If I'm a bachelor, I will have a
bachelor or a bachelor?
Don't you have an extra toothbrush?
Whose is it? It's mine.
Yeah.
Scientifically, it's more than
one. Anyway, I'm sending shout outs to all of you, but that,
I've never seen a player like,
I am with
Mike. Scientifically, you're not supposed to use more than one toothbrush.
Then you're supposed to throw
for
out.
For more than three.
Exactly, for so more than 3 months, you're supposed to throw it out.
Listen, the other one, I use it to clean my toilet thingy.
Oh, and then actually, it so happens that he puts the one that cleans the toilet
with the one that
he uses to brush for home hygienic.
And different thing is.
Which thing is? What are thing is?
I have bathroom.
Yeah, I have three. I have one that cleans my shoes, one for brushing, and one for...
I mean, everyone has extra toothbrushes. Like, for us girls, we have the toothbrush for those with side edge hairs. We have a toothbrush for our teeth. We have a toothbrush for those shoes that you just have to clean a specific way. But there's just that one toothbrush in every bachelor's house. If he hasn't claimed or defined no relationship, trust me, Butai, you will find... And then there's the ones who have a brand new one too. Like, they ready.
We always think outside the box.
They ready.
Just in case.
I don't mean, I just wanted to tell girls, it's all right. It is 2019. Please carry your own toothbrush.
But you can also
stay woke.
Sharing is
good. No, stay woke. Sharing shall is not caring. Be contracting diseases we do
My
not
friend,
know.
Sharing your toothbrush.
I know, right?
It's caring. I mean,
shout out to people from Kamwenje district now over the weekend, actually, because my weekend starts on Friday.
Mine starts on Thursday.
The Minister for Science, Technology and Innovations just made me fall in love with Uganda one more time. Dr. Elioda Tumwesije, this is actually a shout out going to two people, the minister and the people of Kamwenje. He came out and told them that, you know, this year we are going to start making solar buses.
Chow!
And double cabins.
Yeah, man. Wait.
He further said that we were supposed to have our very own cars manufactured by Ugandans 2018, but somehow, somewhere, some financial
Uganda.
Nevertheless, he said and gave assurance that there has been money that has been secured. We are looking at 143 billion Ugandan shillings.
Say what now?
That is to be set aside
for buses in 2019.
No, let him first run back that amount. How much?
143 billion Ugandan shillings. That has been set aside.
My nation is rich.
To have this project running. And apparently, on the better side, he says 24 billion Ugandan shillings has already been secured by the government. So we are going to start having solar buses before 2019 ends. Mark this. He says before the year 2019 ends. And he gives a very simple reason. That's why we're beginning with solar buses. These are going to be public buses so that they can transport people from their areas of residence to Kampala in order to continue with their work. And then they could get into double cabins and then later on small cars.
Me, I think Uganda's biggest problem is not knowing when to use singular and plural.
Thank you. I was just about to arrive at that conclusion.
What is that supposed to mean?
Did he mean we are going to make a solar bus and a double cabin? Or did he mean we're going to make solar buses and double cabins?
Solar buses
and double cabins.
No, you remember last year when they said that
they were
going
to be what is the Kagrini?
I don't know.
Kagrini kaka chatule miyoku teka kukubo. Kavuge kagende yiri yiri. But we are here. We are going to make solar buses. Abi. We have failed. We have failed to make sure that Uganda Airways is up and running. No, but we are going to make solar buses.
No, but the airlines, we actually purchased the airplanes.
But we should be honest with ourselves. Uganda's biggest problem is not buses. As a minister of science, technology, and innovation, let's think about something more innovative. You know, something that would replace charcoal and firewood. You understand?
Oh, he
something
he wants
as sustainable as that.
But they have given you charcoal serving stoves, haven't they?
What are we going to use the solar buses for?
It will transport
to travel.
From where to where?
From your villages.
I mean, we already have more taxis than people.
We are going to remove the taxis
and
put the solar buses.
You know,
and
what?
On the other
Uganda
hand,
it's
going to be free of
no,
charge,
like, you know what? Well, let's just leave it at one thing, right? Uganda needs to learn how to use singular and plural. Simple. If they're going to make buses, yay. If they're going to make a bus, yay. Just don't get it twisted. I'm just saying.
2019 has just begun. Let's wait and
fire.
See.
Let's wait and see by March. Anyway, Father Lokondo has a proposition to make. And he's saying that Pentecostal churches need to be regulated more, that the pastors need to be more educated, and we need to know, in order for us to curb crime and whatever, we need pastors to come through and be more educated before they start a church.
Hey!
Holy Ghost fire!
What
does fire! They should be more educated, like there should be minimum standards. They say S6.
Like a degree in theology?
I don't know, whatever.
Because that's what they did in Rwanda, you know. Now
yes.
You need to have minimum a degree in theology.
In theology, even a certificate in theology.
Pastor Serwada, Pastor Chiganda, and other pastors from different regions. They actually made a conference.
How many pastors?
They made a conference and said, we shall not allow this fulare.
This
we shall not allow this. You people in government do not understand about faith.
Holy Ghost fire.
So can government people go to these churches to pray? How they don't understand about faith? I don't know. And then Pastor Serada actually, and I quote, he says that if the government is jealous of the church, they should come out.
Okay, wait, can I talk now? Can I talk?
But hold on. My opinion now is that if we have a faith, an industry in Pentecostal churches where we have pastors and prophets who can allow someone to kiss your shoe in this dusty Kampala, then I think we need minimum education.
Thank you.
You understand? If we have pastors and prophets who can go collect rice, do whatever, and then tell you when you eat it, that
please,
rice
get
is
an education.
Man, rice is starch. Imagine you're overweight. You understand? And you're eating this. If it was
what
uneducated
the
pastor,
tomato?
They would know. You had, which holy tomatoes?
Yes, the one who was selling holy rice has holy tomatoes too.
And then there's this thing of, I have hankies as pastors and prophets. But if you use my hankies, you will get blessed. You understand? If a pastor is educated, they would understand that if I share my hanky with her, we're probably going to share
this. What was the name of this pastor who was giving out rings?
I don't want to name names. I don't want to give names.
No, I will name names when necessary. But let's be honest. I don't care how many. Zomani Magamba, you do not touch not the anointed man of God.
No, we are not touching.
I'm sorry. I am not touching. I am talking. Now, I believe this is actually good for them. If they do not see that, then they definitely have another thing coming.
At an age,
the pastors, they really need to get an education. At an age, this is going to help your, how do they call them, sheep, flock. If your flock knows that whoever is at the head of the helm has a certain level of regular logic, regular rationale, regular common sense, it helps the flock, because we have seen the flock go astray because of the shepherd. And that's what disturbs, because the shepherd is always supposed to reel them in. But lately, the shepherds are doing all these weird things, and what are the flock doing? They're like, he's the man of God. You are out here prostrating in front of men who are probably not.
Father Lokodo added and said that the media is blaming us, and he's saying, you guys are advertising for churches, and the churches are advertising for orchestrate miracles.
It's commercial journalism. You understand?
No, like he's saying that. No, but we also owe to the public.
We owe it to the people.
Constructive information. Like if you're advertising for a church, but when someone goes to that church, a pastor is creating a miracle. He pays someone to come and act and something miraculous happens.
Let me also.
He's warning the media and saying, guys, stop it. Those things are going to come back and eat you. Me, I've seen young people going to Pentecostal churches to be prayed for to get degrees. And I'm like, the person who is praying for you to get a degree,
he has no idea.
He has no idea. He has no idea of how to get a degree. How do you think you're going to get a degree? Then you go back home, you read your books, work hard, and then later attribute your success to a pastor.
I don't get it. But you know what? At the end of the day, I don't even understand. Why do we advertise a church about Nangi? It has come to that.
In an era where people have choices.
Where this whole thing can be lied from a business. Looking at the business perspective, the economic perspective.
Okay, that's a business.
It's just commercial journalism. So anyone who is into journalism, who owns a media house, would want to bring in that revenue,
that money,
which is going to be used to pay.
At the end
of the day, you wouldn't blame them.
Last week, I said this thing here, and you guys said I was throwing shade. I said... Church is not church no more. It's a business. It's a numbers game. Katwemata musawara kuchite gera. My dear people, I need for people to understand. We walk in this 2019. Muzu, okay. You are out here. Pastor, to say akugambe gule nyanya. Zigenda kuya. Mnewe vuzaka. Nzigule ove ziva. No, you don't buy from the market. Come and get from here. Then another day, they're like, it is holy rice. Another day, they're going to be telling you things like, what happened with the Chibwetere situation? I still.
What
the
about?
Death of me.
So literally,
don't understand how people walked into a church. Closed it, set themselves ablaze.
Pastor Chigana was on TV and he said, an interviewer asked him, don't you think that you owe the public an explanation of how our tithes and offerings go around? And he said, listen, when you have 10K and you give tithe for, 1K 10%. To the church, why should you worry about just 1K? In my head, I'm like,
ciao, it's very many 1K.
1K times 100 people.
Thank you.
You understand? Which brings me to the point. And when I look at people go to church, when you get to church, the first thing that, before praying, some churches are like, banang. No, before that, offertory. Number two, a seed to build the house of God. Yeah. Meanwhile, the church of the house of God
there
is registered.
In Kampala that started building when I was in primary
school. My church is still building.
And meanwhile, the house of God is in the names of the pastor. You understand? The seed to the house of God. Then you're still there, praise and worship. After praise and worship, a seed of faith. Boom, you give a seed of faith. Ah, pastor comes and preaches, first session goes back, someone comes and announces,
offertory. Pastor Muto,
you
are ingina
na now,
offertory.
You have not yet gotten thanks.
Offertory,
a wet day. Kati, choir, nedda ko. Bama ze worship, kat praise. Never praise, na praise, na praise, na praise.
Worship, ne praise.
After praising, tithe. Uh-huh. Because tithe is praising, is giving back to God.
Yes.
You are a tenth of your earnings. After tithing, pastor, nada kukatiao. Now we need preaches. Nagamba, a seed of prosperity. I'm not saying all churches, some churches. You saw the seed of prosperity.
In the church business, my brother.
After that, seed of prosperity, Katinemagamba, Thanksgiving, if you have a child to be baptized, be
sure to
as you are giving the Thanksgiving things along that, the pastor puts
I think aside,
no feeling a thankful to God that you. At the end of the day, a lie on a Sunday.
I tell you, this is what makes us
the biggest entertainment morning, so that you definitely want to be part of. We give you a reason as to why you need to have that blissful smile on your face. But moving away from that, we want to take you through how the weather forecast is likely to unfold today. Here is our weather forecast for the 7th of January 2019. Moving serious matters onto the forefront, please let's not just give out on churches. Please let's continue going to church and let's continue praying to our God, because we just need to be thankful at the end of the day. But nevertheless, one man's meat is another man's poison, and one word for a wise man is always enough. Moving away from that, of course, we want to keep this show on the road. Getting last night online, what did we have? An interesting tweet did come up from one of the most interesting controversy ladies on Twitter. Let's have that tweet up on our timeline. Right there, it goes from Lady Malaika.
No, okay. Lady Malaika says, ladies, if you have a pass or two that you do not use or need or want anymore, fill it with snacks, sanitary and hygiene products. The next time you see a homeless woman, give it to her. Happiness is only real when shared. Never forget, sharing is caring. And she hashtags that off with hashtag faith over fear. I find that really beautiful.
That giving
let them
is better than you spending your 100K in church. Can we go back for
There are churches
that have mobile money numbers.
Yes, and they put them on the screen. You have to keep
even sending on envelopes of type.
By the way, wow. Anyway, I'm just saying, Lady Malaika, this tweet is honestly, this is what I hashtag and say humanity all the time. Humanity is always surprising. It's always becoming. And teaching, you don't lose nothing. I have a couple of purses that I have not used in years. And when I read this tweet, I'm like, you know what? Tomorrow, that's what I'm finna do. So, because there are people out there who could use this. There are people out there who need this. Buli choli nanga tochi kozesa. This whole nonsense of you running around and taking pictures mbuyu helped. Mubi kwate, mubi twale, ababe taga jevali. I always tell people, like my girlfriends, if you have clothes that you haven't put on in over 2 months, get a plastic bag, put everything in, and take to your nearest church.
You know what? When I read this tweet, I'm like, okay, it opens my mind into asking myself, how do the homeless and, you know, the women in, on Kampala streets handle menstrual periods?
Exactly. And
it's a very ugly, sensitive issue that we could...
Yeah. That is
so
something.
You put some of the pads and
stuff. Everything, put sanitary, put hygiene. You never know who you're blessing and at what. And you people, let me tell you, karma is a beautiful thing. The same reverb you give is the same reverb you get back. Mm-hmm. You help like that. You do not know who you're helping and how it's going to, you know, benefit them or benefit you. So go ahead. Let's have a heart. Because that's what keeps us together.
The heart that giveth.
This morning,
first of all, I deliberately said no to that because I believe a grown up man.
Have you just brought your private issues on air?
A grown up man needs
Let's
to know how to buy
from that. I'll give you a reason as why you do need to grab yourself a copy of the New Vision book, and not forgetting letting you know on what is making headlines in different newspapers, both on the East African level and in international level, on our press digest. I right, the beauty about the new vision every single Monday is that we do have plenty of jobs for you who's actually watching us and even interested in switching jobs, or even you have been unemployed for a couple of months or even years. It's about that time that you do grab yourself a copy of the new vision at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings, and down in Kenya it is 107 for Tanzanian shillings, 1,600, and for the Rwandan francs, that is 933. They do have over 540 jobs that could be up for grab. Now, make sure that you do grab yourself a copy. And then they're looking at the title right here, the headline, they're saying, Land Boss Baguma Isoke in Trouble. Police summon him over fraudulent Mulago deal. Now, get a copy of the new vision, get to catch up with that story on page 6. Now, on the health tip, they talk about how regular checkups can save you. A couple of Ugandans usually tend to, you know, miss out on this, but how important are the regular checkups in terms of your health? Get a copy of the new vision and get to catch up with that detailed story on page 33 and 34. President meets AAU, that is of course UAE investors, get to catch up with that, United Arab Emirates, as well as a couple of other stories right here in the Holy Day Companion, and a couple of others making headlines in the new vision.
And of course, a quick look at your book and touch. Now, of course, the biggest headlines that they have: Munyagwa ne kasiba anteban bani sekadaga ne katunju. Of course, that will delve into that.
Munyagwa had recorded a video in India saying that he's coming back.
We can't.
He's going to drop names.
Not today. We shall not.
I mean.
And then they say, Bukenya Yazala Babidi Ewanjuba. There's a very sad story here. Someone passed on there. I want to delve into it. Now, getting back to churches. Oh, you're in. Dokita Bamukutewa Kusobia Kumuluadi. Wamuni. Then the headline that has killed it for me. Abasengua. Mulwera. Bagala. Nabika Kande. Abalayidide.
Abasasule to compensate.
I was like,
compensation. You know, someone settles on land, they become a settler or a squatter. So when they are leaving, probably after some time,
they want settlement from the church. Them. Now, we all know this is the same church that had holy rice, holy tomatoes.
And you remember before the holy rice?
They had the tomatoes as well.
Yes, they have everything. They have a holy basket fruit. And everything.
When it is said that guy has a huge chunk of land.
A huge one. And the followers and the church are the ones who dig there. They look after it. They do everything. It's a community. The economy keeps growing. Meant to be a daddy. To turn up a daddy.
Zadze.
What is in the Daily Monitor?
In the Daily Monitor, one of the biggest stories, and this story started, I think, months ago, and when someone tweeted and said the British MPs should mind their own business. So in the Daily Monitor is running and saying British MPs to debate rule of law in Uganda.
Say what?
Hey.
Okay.
It's like they, me I would say, man, let this guy sit on Brexit.
No, this
they
is
have
what I'm
more important to, issues to
I'm
talk
sorry,
about
this is
than,
what I'm
than
going
Uganda.
To say. The old proverb still holds a lot of water. Stop looking at the speck in my eye and look at the big, huge log lodged between your eyes. Simple.
There's an $8 billion food deal that is causing a storm in Parliament. The Daily Monitor has that story on page 6. I won't go into details to that, but I will jump onto the sports section of the Daily Monitor. And they are saying that Simba's venomous press conference remarks spark controversy. One of his statements was, we were 11 against 14. The referees were biased. You could also see that. Wow. Another comment was, only that you are here among the Vasoga. If it was your team, if they had cheated you, you would be bitter just like me. This was the robbery. That's the Daily Monitor giving me some controversial stories there. And then why always Golola, according to Vipers, that's at the back of the Daily Monitor. Internationally, though, The Guardian has a very interesting story that DRC has actually delayed.
They postponed
presidential election results.
Okay.
So it has been going on since December.
First it was the voting.
Yes.
I know.
And then there has this whole excuse of Ebola. We couldn't, carry out some elections in different areas. And now, of course, we went past that. We saw the president cast his vote. And now they have gotten to a point of postponing presidential elections.
Let me get this right. Like, either this government needs to be dumb, or they just don't know how to play their game and their cards right. Like, there are people.
They should talk.
I think that's
the problem with Ugandans. We have
not to judge. No, I'm not. This is just me having my random opinion. So they cast the ballot, right?
Yes.
And then you want to keep it for how long?
For a week or two.
For a week or two. Then after a week or two, they are not counting. They're just saying they have stopped.
No, they said they are delaying. Announcing of results.
Yes. So they are counting.
No, why are you assuming that?
I don't know, are they counting?
Maybe they are taking the results around the country so they can announce on the same day.
What are they doing? What are they doing? The change of
government
right now.
None of us is in Congo.
The thing is, Congo, Congo anyway. Is one of the largest African countries.
Demographically,
you can understand that the country is large, so they need more resources to galvanize all these resources.
Oh, so this is their first election?
No, I'm saying that's what I'm saying.
This is their first election that they don't know how to deal with it.
Is that Congo has been hit with Ebola for quite some time now. That's an issue that can affect.
Before you continue with your points, can I introduce you to the viewers at the PRO of the ruling party?
No, I'm not the PRO of the ruling party. I'm just trying to be as fair as possible here.
Because people have always compared
how Africans lead their countries and do their things to the Western world. We cannot be the United States of America. This is Africa. We do things our way.
Why can't we be the United States of America?
We are not. First of all, we got our independence hundreds of years later. Mm. You understand? Congo is large. We have Ebola. You're talking about people.
Soldiers, war.
Instability itself.
So you'd understand when these guys say, let's take a few days. Now it's upon the opposition and people who want to get to replace the incumbent to be more vigilant that the results they announce when they decide to announce.
This is something we have seen in Africa.
When they decide. Because now I'm trying. Guys, let's be honest. You're trying to be all politically correct. Let me be politically incorrect. Mm. I do not cast my ballot on a Monday, right? Mm. And then you tell me we're going to have to wait a week, even if it's 4 days. Because naturally we know, like you say, TIA, we can't be America, but again, we are African. There's a lot of things that go down when a ballot is cast. Mm. Now, the fact that they are cast and they're put in a room, what are the chances that whoever it is that wants to do whatever it is that they want to do can't do with them that?
Well, because you need to be able to trust your institutions, police, and
by the look of things that have been going down in Congo.
Mm-hmm. Where is it written that when I cast a vote on Monday, by Monday night I should expect
nowhere.
You're trying to copy systems that are not ours.
You know what? You when they will give you the results.
I'm sorry, just like any other African country, members of opposition will come out.
In Africa, for example, it is common for a family to postpone lunch. In Western countries, it is not. But in Africa, it's absolutely understandable that your father says, you know what?
Lunch.
And in Africa, we don't have
dinner at 6 p.m.
How? No. It is at 10.
But in the U.S., 6 p.m. You're like, how?
This is evening. So wait, we're just going to put this all on the fact that this is Africa.
This is Africa.
But at the end of the day, we do hope and pray that whatever results come out, everybody is satisfied and nobody feels like they're robbed or anything.
Of course, I'm very expectant, looking out for those people who will be not very, very okay with
the opposition.
You have nothing to do, you have no evidence. But anyway, moving on from that, at this point in time, Urban Today takes a very quick break. But when we do get back, we want to find out what we have for you at TX7. Just keep it right here with us on Urban Television. Back from that short break, and of course, you're still hanging with the trio right here on Urban Today, Derica, Willis Daly, and of course, Tina Fia is taking you up to 8 a.m. Get in touch with us onto our social media pages. For Facebook, it is Urban Television, and for Twitter, it is at Urban TV Uganda. Use the hashtag Urban Today. You can tag me at Aina Dash on Twitter as well as Tina Fia Swan and Willis Daly. That is, of course, our official handles. But moving on from that, it's about that time we do get you some tea at 7. We hope that you have some tea in your cup. But looking at our story this morning, of course, have to send it to the big twos that have made history right now as we speak. Bebe Cool and Bobby Wine. And now over the weekend, these two met at a particular function, apparently. And there was that kind of glimpsey handshake and hug coming in from Bebe Cool and Bobby Wine. Now, looking at how we have unfolded the events of the political atmosphere in the country, the musical atmosphere in the country, recently we saw what Bebe Cool did and, of course, made of himself at a particular TV station, and we have seen the wrangles that have unfolded because of these two people having different ideologies as far as political parties is concerned. And then here they are at a function and they're hugging themselves like, I haven't seen you in a long time. I missed you, bruh. What do you guys make of this handshake?
Because this is way up my alley. Mm. When I first saw the images go up on social, yo, there was so much power. There was so much power in just those images of them holding hands and giving each other a hug. But the image that actually mellowed down for me and made me feel different about the whole situation is how Bobby and Bebe were greeting each other. There was so much respect in that image on both parties.
And Bobby or Bobby?
Bobby.
Okay.
Because he did greet everyone at the table. And then I was like, this is so beautiful. This is what I keep telling people all the time. Mm-hmm. If we don't pit them against each other, they could actually both have their own political views, but still stay friends. Peoples, you know, not friends. Mm-hmm. Peoples, you know, colleagues. Then
acquaintances.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And then as I'm still revealing in that and loving how beautiful it was, then the stories come. They're like, oh, well, don't get it twisted, because Bebe Cool had already bought his table. Mm. We all saw that. He publicized that. So Bebe Cool bought his table. When he walked in, the Katikiro of Buganda happened to be seated on one table with Bobby Wine. So he was supposed to come and say hi. Now, you don't, just in African culture, just what I kubuza
munjo.
So because Bobby and Bobby were all seated on the same chair, he did it intentionally, because you all saw that photo of him holding both of their hands and he's standing in the middle. It was a good initiative for him, you know, it was a good moment for us. And what was even much more better is that he came out wearing red. I wanted to applaud his PR team on that, because the day before when he said all those remarkable weird things on TV, he was as bright as a banana baby. So when he came out in red and then we saw this, hi, hello, like, what's good, bruv? You know, do you, I'm doing me. It was so beautiful.
Do you think he actually thought that he would meet Bobby Wine?
He knew he was going to meet him there, but then, this is the part that people didn't understand. Immediately after all those handshakes and, you know, the very many photos, because many people took photos in different angles, he walked back to his table. So, it leaves the question, could this be the beginning of an understanding that, hey, look here, you stand here, I stand here, but as humans, we can relate. And I've had Bebe Cool say it before, people just never want to hear. He said it when I first heard what had happened to Bobby Wine. Mm. I was in tears, because that's a man.
He's supposed to put food on the table for his family.
So I think, who knows, maybe I'm not going to speculate really. But if this could be a working situation, kind of like the way that Uhuru's and the Raila Odinga family are, like, they will blast themselves on different social media platforms politically, but as families, they're actually friends. They have dinner almost every day together.
Daily, what would you make of that remarkable instance of Bobby Wine and Bebe Cool shaking hands and even hugging?
For starters, number one, I believe that we are giving musicians and people in the music industry a space on the political table, which is absolutely wrong.
Too wrong.
Because the musicians that we're putting there are not even qualified musicians. You understand?
Why?
No, as a country, and in Africa, where politicians make decisions for how a country is run, we need someone who is a professional and experienced in a certain field. You understand? These guys only bring experience. They're not professionals.
They bring just the numbers.
Bobby Wine studied MGD at Makerere University. He studied a diploma in MGD. Someone brought me down and said, no, you're being wrong. Bobby Wine is being low. He is just doing low now.
Yes,
you understand? What experience will he have? You understand? That's why we have mistakes like Katol Wama in Parliament.
Ooh, did you understand? Just call it
anyway,
a mistake?
To go to the handshake.
The handshake, yes.
Number one, kudos to the Katikiro of Buganda for, you know, being the uniting factor in this too. Number two is that people need to separate business from personal feelings. These guys' wives are friends. like they are gangos. The kids BFFs. Are gangos. You understand? Mm. So when someone comes and says, oh, Bobby Wine hates Bebe Cool, Bebe Cool hates Bobby Wine, it's absolutely nonsense. Mm-hmm. They had interviews, both of them, after that. Bebe Cool said, Bobby Wine must apologize to me for abusing my family and father. Mm. Now, ideally, after a handshake like this, you would expect Bobby Wine to say, you know what? I think it's time we apologize. But guess what? He wants to prolong the joke.
The joke.
Yeah? So he says in the interview that there are things that we did in the past that we are not proud of. And the journalist asked him, will you apologize to Bebe Cool? He refused to answer that question.
Deliberately.
He's just trying to prolong the beef so that people can continue to go to concerts, buy the music. But for how long shall we have this nonsense?
The numbers, and I'm glad you're saying...
So are you trying to say that literally what Bobby Wine did was more of a dramatic scene?
It was business. Petty. Both of them are just because being dimwits.
He had the right... So actually not greet biblical, you know. If you greet me,
no, he had no right.
No.
He had
I mean,
no right.
Yes.
I'm going to give you an example.
I'm going to give you an example of respect. And I'm sorry that I have to use the head of state as an example, but this is the right time to use this example. We have seen an instance where my mama Babazi and President Yoweri Museveni fell out, and there was this clip that went viral when President Yoweri Museveni, you know, moved out of his car, and then he was greeting so and so. Then he greeted. Then he didn't greet Amam and Babazi. He just actually continued walking. Mm-hmm. So this is literally what I'm trying to say here, that if Bobby Wine felt like what he was going to say after or during that interview could have not made any sense to this handshake, he would have as well even stayed in his chair.
No, the thing is, you confuse two things. Number one, politics is capitalism. Politics has no morals.
True.
So Museveni could choose to or not to. Mm. But here you're talking about culture, morals,
and
you
everything.
We've been indoctrinated to believe.
If you want to portray that as your number one kind of priority, then why get the side of the interview whereby, you know, you've been put on a spot and you can't answer as to why you cannot apologize? You're looking at culture.
With a handshake. With a handshake. You know? Let me also give you an example.
Why is he giving us two sides?
If I met a friend of mine at probably an event, a wedding of our friend, I could choose not to greet them. But if I met that same friend in front of my father, regardless of our differences, I have no choice. So these two are brothers. They are Buganda brothers. Mm. The Katikilo was a representative of Buganda, and the father of Buganda, which is the Kabak of Buganda.
So there was
no way one of them would say, let me not, because the story would change differently.
But now, you know what? I feel like that's more confusion for me.
I don't know, you're but personally, I would like to call a spade a spade.
Okay, true.
If I have issues with you, I don't care whether you're standing next to my father or my mother. I'm going to greet my mom and my dad, and I'm not going to greet you. It's that simple.
No, let's put it like this. Like he said, personally, I'm tired of all this nonsense. I'm tired of the pertinence. I'm tired of the little girl tactics. Because we saw this, and what was so calming about these images is that when we put the images out on social media, the masses were excited. They didn't care which color, which place, which denomination. They all just humbled down. And then minutes later, both of these dimwits come out and they're like, oh no, we never made up. We didn't expect.
No, I think actually Bebe Cool was more mature in this.
Yes,
because
Bebe
he said,
was,
guys,
was mature.
Me, my problem is that this guy insulted my family, and
I want him
to me.
Yes, and I want him to apologize. And then Bobby Wine on
did
the
not
other
step what he wanted.
Did not step what
and,
he
and
wanted.
And
for
him, Bebe Cool insulted
Bobby Wine. For him, what he said, and actually he's shooting himself in the foot, because for him, what he said, he said that.
Oh, but Bobby
Wine. He said that. There are more important things to talk about, which is Uganda. What forms Uganda?
The people,
the citizens.
Where do the people come from?
They are from everywhere, but they are
Ugandans. People in Uganda come from families, meaning that the family is the most important. So when you don't address that issue, how do you say that you're addressing more important issues?
Let me tell you something. This is what pissed me off the most about his statement when he came on national radio. I was like, wait, dude, you have kids. when this whole saga was going on, you were telling us how your kids wrote you letters and how all this and that and that. And you were talking about the unit, the family unit. Now, a grown man too comes out and tells you, look, my issues with you is that you say this and this and this about my blood, my peoples, my family. Just apologize and let's walk away. And you deliberately refuse to do so. For me, it's just, you know what, all gloves are off.
But I also want to blame Ugandans at large. We Ugandans, we the media people have
Too much fire.
Yeah, we have failed to move on. We have very good artists out there.
These are two core artists.
No, what do you mean core? What do you mean core?
I mean, it's biblical and God.
Yeah, the last time Bobby White's music was relevant in my life.
I'm not saying it's relevant. What I'm saying is, really, these are the people who have helped shape the industry. Come on, guys. Let us give credit where it is due. You know, let us give credit where it is due. It was always Bebekool, Bobby Wine, and Chameleon. Do you guys agree with that?
No.
Let us first agree.
I want to give you an education. Are you going to agree?
Are you going to agree that it was?
I want to give you.
Do you agree?
I'm not going to. I want to give you an education in your music.
Let me listen to the education. Let me listen to
it. You cannot tell me that it was just Bebekool, Bobby Wine, and Chameleon who brought the sound that we have. No. This movement started a long time ago. We had Primon Proper. We had Steve Jim. We had what was his name? Peter Sematin. But those are the people who gave you all
Let me give you a break.